kept team secret in order to take a win. And I feel like going into this finals, that was the way I was looking at it too. Can PPD essentially outdraft team secret? He does it beautifully in the lane, will push Zai into his
trouble.
Favor.
Bottom lane, the Stormbolt's going to come in. They're trying to get around it for the heal bomb, and there it is. Zai's in trouble. And first blood, spilt by evil geniuses. That's what they tried to do.
This is not visible by any Radiant Ward. And in fact, if Kuro walks around the corner now, he'll probably scout at Universe. There's a lot of support coming down to Zai. Hook shot in, Puppy's going to start the Illuminate, already use it. In fact, it's on cooldown. Fear triggering the God Strike. The cogs are up, and with the bolt, they'll kill him off. The Fear being picked up. Raise number one, the Illuminate.
Oh, the Puppy! Perfect time, and Universe still alive. The six times are there, but the attack from S4 will hit its mark. The tracks are up from Aoi. They're chasing after Kuro, not to mention the rest.
Meganims, or what have you, for the Keeper of the Light. Shutting down his farm is not the most paramount thing for evil geniuses.
Kuro is still tracked up on the back lines, and S4 moves forward. Well, he sees the EG Kuro moving forward, and Fear, Stormbolt, maybe he can kill off Kuro with one swipe, two. Okay, well, that'll do it. With the rocket also hopping out, S4's on the run, but Fear moving so quickly back behind that tier 2 tower. Stormbolt in 4 seconds time, a little bit too far away, but the rocket's still coming. S4, nice regenerating time, but that's going to go down the Puppy. Now he's in trouble with the Stormbolt connecting on both. They've got the movement speed because of the track, but still 2-for-1, and Arteezy's joined the fight. They're back into a three-man wall, and the Aoi and 18 HP, the illusion from Darkseer will get the kill. Samael try and dodge as much as he possibly can around the tree lines. The surge is up, he's TPing out between the trees, and Arteezy finding the mark, finding another kill, going 3-for-1 on this end. That's your hook shot going on the middle lane. It's Universe. He's in there with Zai and Kuro with the heal. Actually doing some nice return damage. Tarzan's drag back and Sun into Fear. Even Stormbolt being stolen. Hitting in to that poor Sven who cannot keep up. And Zai on 93 life running back in. Maybe he can survive. The track is on him. Okay, he will not survive. Down for the count. The Rockets are also scouting out Puppy, but no hookshot available. Fear triggers the war cry. They want to dive underneath the tier 2 tower. Universe can tank quite a hefty amount. Goes for the Illumin, any kind of damage he can do. And S4 lining up the Requiem of Souls. Not really in range, but then again with the raids on a Fear. Universe is still in the trees. Fear, one attack will get the kill. He blinks forward. But Kuro is waiting for him. Gets a sudden Aoi, and as he steals Shuri Toss, well, he already threw it. I mean,
a little bit of push at top lane, but that's Universe quickly dealt.
Hookshot, that range is too far away. He's not going to make it. They just give up.
There's no way they go for that fight. I mean, that would be a complete suicide play to try and basically steal Aegis and then...
Still sitting on the cliff. Actually, I say that, it now times out. They had really good vision to go in through this tower. So it has to be redone by Puppy, who's coming down now. And in fact, he's recalling in the troops. The Radiant Tower, there's your jump in from S4. Requiem, and they want to blow up here. Decent damage, enough to kill him. Well, it looks like it will be. Fear's down for the count. The man on the tree line. I also open up. Teezy just pops the bounty as well as the Tinker and goes for more. The Cox from Universe will keep him out. But the damage has already been done to both the tier 2 tower as well as the heroes of EG.
Yeah, later on in this game, the Scythe of Ice constant control against the Animage is a counter to him in a way, but in this part of the game, Animage just trumps Tinker every single time. Once he starts throwing out some of that mana, a big mana void will almost instantly kill him.
Now the tier 3 tower almost gone. No fortification available for evil geniuses. They buy back over on the Sven. They want to try and hold Universe again with a cold push on the Animage, but he's still also got Aegis Immortal. Kuro pick him up and Fear! Picked up in with the Stormbolt. Zai gonna back it back up. He'll still end up dying, but for what cost? You've actually lost Fear for 70 seconds. Arteezy has ran the base, jumped in for the double kill on the Dazzle. They will finish up the melee Rex. The only lane they could go to is bottom because this tier 2 tower still survives in the mid. And backdoor regen will protect it, but they're going to push it anyway.
They feel so comfortable that they just leave S4 to that top lane to finish off that last Rags. They're even running through the tier 2, which they should take, but Tinker's going to try and make a play here.
He jumps in, but Arteezy's only there. S4 moving the front lines once again. Hulk pushing him back. Universe, great positioning. And the explodes the mail as well as Aoi. Two on the sideline again. It's a double man. GG! The Void is big, and Secret are shoving EG down into it. 2-1, and will EG be denied once again here on the ESL 1 Frankfurt stage? Secret, one win away from success.
Again, Secret just providing that constant pressure. The rotations out from them was beautiful. They set up enough room for Arteezy to start getting ahead. And once he was able to lock onto that Battle Fury, you knew he was going to have an excellent game. And boy, those mana voids turned out big.